become so widespread in Russia? And to answer that, we need to go back in time to the early 1990s. Boris Yeltsin flew into Alma-Ata in buoyant mood. He had come to bury the Soviet Union and to build the new Commonwealth.
Yeah, I was studying it when the Soviet Union fell down.
That's Mariana Pogorelskaya. These days, she's an associate professor at Nottingham Trent University. She focuses on climate politics in Russia. But back in the 1990s, she was living with her family in Siberia.
The decision of the Soviet Union left people in very vulnerable position. People didn't know how to provide for their families. So throughout the 90s, issues like global warming were not on people's minds.
And then in the year 2000, something changed. Vladimir Putin became president.
One of the tasks of the new president's administration was to kind of reboot the state from the ground. And one of the foundations of that became the energy sector.
The production of oil and gas.
So that became quite an important contribution to the country's GDP.
So much so, it turned it into a symbol, a rallying point for this new Russia President Putin was trying to build.
Finding pride in what Russia is, and it's a great country with huge, vast natural resources, and resources that the whole world relies on.
It's during these years, the early 2000s, that the conversation around global warming started to shift in Russia. You just have to look at the way journalists cover the story.
It's very interesting how in the 90s, even though climate change was not part of the agenda, the message was very strong, the importance of climate change. And then in 2000s, we see the appearance of the climate skepticism, doubting, denialism, various formations. And there was a big economic aspect saying that Russia just started getting itself out of that economic collapse, so it's going to restrict our growth.
And the truth is, the oil and gas industry has now grown so much, it represents about 15% of Russia's GDP. In other words, fossil fuels bring in big money, which might explain why alternative views began to emerge.